In this video, we'll cover more on domain names and expand upon where we left off in the last video. The most important part of a URL is the domain extension, or the last part of the domain name. Some common domain extensions are .com for commercial businesses, .org for nonprofit organizations, .gov for government agencies, .edu for educational institutions, .mil for military, .int for international treaty organizations, and .net for network organizations. The most common domain extensions are .com, .org, .gov, and .edu. When evaluating, the domain extension helps reveal the purpose of the web page or website. However, all websites and web pages should be evaluated regardless of the domain name. Now, let's take a closer look at each of these domain extensions. .com domain extensions are used by for-profit entities, retailers such as Target or Amazon, companies making profit through advertising such as the New York Times or CNN, informational sites such as the Internet Movie Database, and social networking sites such as Facebook, Pinterest, or Twitter. In many cases, the content is written by journalists or other professionals, but not necessarily scholars in the field. When analyzing the page, verify the accuracy and agreement with other sources. Look for the bias or point of view. We'll cover bias more in the evaluation sections later in the course. Amazon.com's purpose is to sell products and services. For CNN.com, advertising is one of their main sources of income. News sites can provide accurate information, but just because it's on the news doesn't mean it's true. Sometimes news sites are influenced by investors, advertisers, or political agendas. Some of the news reported can be incomplete or influenced by regional or local interests. Verify the information you found using other sources. Here are two news stories about the same event. Both have different information. The content in the highlighted passage on the Fox News site does not appear in the CNN story. .org domain extensions are used by nonprofit organizations like the American Heart Association, the National Rifle Association, the March of Dimes, and the American Civil Liberties Union. Content on these pages is written by members of the organization who may not be scholars or experts in the field. When analyzing the page, find the mission statement, and this will help reveal the bias. Also, verify the accuracy of the information and agreement with other sources. When analyzing a .org page, find the agenda or mission. This will help reveal the bias. The purpose of a .org website is to advance the organization's agenda or mission. .gov domain extensions are used by government agencies like the White House, the National Institutes of Health, and the Federal Citizen Information Center. Content on these pages is written by government employees who may not be experts in the field. When analyzing these pages, find the organization's mission, which will reveal the bias. And as with the other types of pages, verify accuracy and agreement with other sources. The Federal Citizen Information Center, an example of a gov site, covers many topics to help protect consumers. .edu domain extensions are used by schools, colleges, and universities. Information on these pages may be written by staff members, scholars in a field, or students. When analyzing these pages, verify the accuracy and agreement with other sources. Find the author's credentials to determine whether he or she is qualified to write about the topic, and find the bias. Educational websites can be reliable and unbiased. Authors generally create information to inform other researchers and educate the general public. When the author's credentials are unknown, check that the information is correct by using other reliable sources. The author for this webpage is a Washington State University graduate, but we can only assume that she graduated from veterinary school and not another department. In this case, the author is clearly linked and her credentials are obvious. This author is qualified to write about the topic. Now, complete the activity for this video.